First pitch of 2023 delivered, ball one by Ryan Ammons. This season, especially last year for the Tigers. Skied pretty well. That's left well center hit. Field. Gonna carry out of here. What a way to start 2023.
Would have carried out of here regardless, but it was well hit. But great start for Blake Wright and the Tigers.
Hit 11 home runs a year ago, did Wright. And that one gonna count to 3-1. That's why our home plate umpire turned around. And what do you know? First plate appearance as a college player, and Canelo reaching on the walk. Number of pitches. Chopped to third. Bade bobbles. Might have had a chance that he picked it up cleanly, but safe at first. Corbett first and second action with two away for the Tigers. In this case, this weekend, to the opposing head coach. Roselli, he bobbles. And the stretch made at first. And Gazelle saving another would-be era. Five appearances, 27 and a third. And two consecutive strikeouts, this one looking, and that's out number one in the second. A league that includes Maine and New Jersey Tech, UMass Lowell, Binghamton among others, and back-to-back strikeouts to start the second, three in a row now for Ammons. And that can be a really difficult pitch to handle. Skied on the left side, the left fielder, Crichton, the freshman, puts it away. You know, roughly a decade and a half as a head coach. Four-pitch walk to start things out for Blackwell here in the second. Best we can tell, he's not related to the famous author by the last name. Blackwell makes it easy. Stole that one on the pitcher.
No doubt. Got a great jump.
Has worked the count full. That should get the run home. Deep short. Bobbled.
Boy.
Safe all around. 2-0 Tigers.
You've got to put the ball in play.
Ripped. That time knocked down by Gazelle. No way that they were going to be able to get Grice. Decent speed getting from home to first. We're going to call it an infield hit.
Yep. Out of necessity because of the weather.
Chopped to third. Bade second for one. On to first.
Well done.
5-4-3. Throw just beating Bertram. Riffler stands in and rips it past the second baseman Bertram. First hit of the game for Binghamton. Tommy Riffler. Longest outing. Two innings. Didn't mean to. And a little floater into left field. And now, first and second, back-to-back singles. That time, Corey, just an excuse-me swing, but he was able to get it past the reach of Blake Wright at third. The quarterback played shortstop. And he lines this one into left center field. Going to get a run home. Three straight hits. Sliding in is Reifler with a first run of the season for Binghamton, and they cut the Tigers' advantage in half. Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. Strikeout at just the right time for out number two here in the third. Especially with that changeup working. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. Second time Roselli goes down on strikes. Great job working his way around the base pass. There is a drive high and
well
deep
hit
to left. Off the bat of Wright and gone again. Almost the exact same spot. It's deja vu all over again. Two for two with a couple of long balls to start out the campaign for Wright.
Wow, and you're exactly right. They just very similar swings and location.
Ripped into center field.
Right.
He reached base via walk in his first appearance. Now he's got his first collegiate hit. Still haven't seen the scoring and couldn't pick up if they gave Cannarella the stolen base. Left side. Corey, the shortstop. Wynn taking it to left.
Is that Wynn?
Everybody's safe. Now the runner at third, Cannarella, had to return to the bag and hold, but look at the hustle into second by Corbett.
Good
point. Looks like we're going to get another error in the inning, and that'll be three to get him to third. Left field. See if it stays fair. It does. One hops the wall. Ferry will pull into second with a two-run double. The lead grows to 5-1. Tigers taking advantage of fielding issues from Binghamton, and big hit delivered by one of the veterans.
And that's a big guy not to have in your lineup. He really, really handles the bat well. See how they deal with this pop fly.
Boy, the wind giving Bade fits, but he's able to put it away for out number three.
67 degrees, so it's about 1 o'clock. And there's a strikeout, but When I got to Clemson, it was about 58. It is now 49.
Nine a year ago.
Boy.
And throw to first to make it official. Second strikeout in the inning, now 7-4.
And not swing at pitches in the dirt.
Again, he hits it to the right side. Gazelle, pitcher covers, and Bryce beats it out. Got there a step before the pitcher, Babalus. Ball four, first and third, still nobody out. And now Wright ripped past the diving shortstop, Corey. Grice comes home. Bertram had to wait. He'll end up at third. Three RBIs in the game now for Blake Wright. The lead grows to 6-1. Popped up left side. Long run for Reifler. Able to make the catch. Runner at third tags, and coming across, Bertram. So a sac fly RBI, another effective at bat for Canarella, and it's 7-1. For now, 8 hits, 7 runs. Runner trying to advance. Throw gets away. Wow. Corbett will come home, and the Tigers build the lead to 8-1. And what do you know? Another error for Binghamton.
Ooh.
That is their fourth so far. Chad Ferry pops it up on the left side. Again, the wind blowing out that way. Long run for Reifler. For out number three, made a really nice catch in foul territory on the...
Yep.
Got him to chase low.
Yep.
Eighth strikeout so far for Ryan Ammons. Two away quickly here in the fifth.
Three straight fastball.
Called strike three. Boy, Ammons setting up his pitch as well. 1-2. Corey at short. Second hop. And Gazelle unable to dig it out of the dirt. A fifth error in the game on the Binghamton team. And he is on the move. That one skied high and deep to left field by Gerald. Reifler on the run at the wall, and it's gone. Newfangled game of Twister.
Well, getting a little ab work in.
Yeah. First pitch swinging to start out the Binghamton eighth is Reifler, and the left fielder on. Emmons faced and was the ninth and final strikeout. Seeing eye ground ball, and he's got a second hit. And two men on to start things out for Binghamton here in the eighth. And that's ripped into left field for a base hit. They'll wave the runner. And coming across with the second run of the game for Binghamton is Reifler. 10-2 ball game. Give Gunning his first run batted in. Lined into left. That one's going to get down. Crichton had to play the hop. Runners will move up 90 feet. Bases now loaded with one away. And again in the six. Runs into one here. Deep left center field. Canarella back on the hill. Able to make the grab. Nice play by the freshman center fielder, limiting that to a sac fly. And again, getting used to the dimensions of Doug Kingsmore Stadium and the fact that runner Roselli goes in the air to right. Ferry. And that does it for Binghamton here in the eighth. And a walk. So add that to a 4-for-4 day with a couple of home runs and three batted in. A terror on the base pass for opposing pitchers and catchers. On the move, Canarella. And he's probably going to get razzed by the dugout for the Tigers. Give Canarella the 11th stolen base of the game, and that's fair. Inside the left field line. Canarella will score easily. Taylor will motor into second with a pinch hit RBI double. Makes it an 11-3 game. And you know, Will Taylor didn't get the start today because had some nagging injuries, one of the Tigers in that category, but you know, he feels great and happy to be able to get in the lineup to start the season. And we will have it for you right here if you can't make it out. Center field for Haskell, and the Tigers are done here in the eighth inning. In the home eighth inning, and well, an opportunity to reach base in his first plate appearance for Stelrec, so he'll trot down to first. Another player from Long Island on this Binghamton team from Great Neck, New York. Chops it on the right side. Grice to second, one. Return throw by Bertram, and a double play to end it. Nice way to cap off an opening win for the Tigers in 2023. And for the man in the middle wearing the number 23. Mm-hmm.